Everyone, I hope you're having a brilliant day today. It's Esther here, excuse me, from the Gold Coast, Australia, and I'm here to continue patterning on this gorgeous creature, the marlin. So we're doing water today, and I've got a few scribbles here. But I'll just put this light on. And we'll get started. I've been babysitting today. It's been absolutely delightful. Now I'm at home. What we're going to do is we need to show that this is water and that this guy has jumped out of the water. So that's what I'm trying to indicate here. So it's not exactly Zen tangling, but it's just a patterning. And so we'll get started. So I've got a few lines that we made in the previous one, and I'm just going to continue along that line there. If you remember, I made all these marks the last time. And I've got some pencil lines here, which I'm just going to rub out quickly. Just so that things don't get confusing. There we are. Page is clean of pencil lines, I hope. And what we do in these sections is, well, I'm going to do circles along these. Now we've done that before. So let's do that now. So we've got two lines. And you just do circles according to the size of your lines. And I'll scroll in so that you can see how to do that. It's very easy. And it gives a lovely effect. So you've got two lines and you're doing circles all the way along those lines. Getting bigger and bigger or smaller and smaller. And it would just add to the effect of water. And then you fill in the negative spaces between the circles here. I hope you are all enjoying working alongside with me. That's why I don't speed up my videos, so that you can do what I'm doing and you can just relax while doing it. And all these patterns are just marks on a page. A drawing is just marks on a page. Think of it that way. Some people put the marks better than others. And some not so great. But if you think of it, there's some artists who do their marks on pages, and you're actually shocked when you look at them and you think, wonder the hell these people get millions of dollars. I'll explain a little bit. Like Picasso, for example, in his early days, he was a brilliant artist. He's done some beautiful realistic work. But he's more famous for when he went outside the norm. And why he's so famous for that is he changed the history of art. He and a few of his compatriots. So art used to be everything's realistic and three-dimensional. And suddenly someone comes along and just turns it on its head and does something completely different. And it was a while before it was accepted, but when it was accepted, my God, it just changed everything. And that's why we today can do stuff like this. Because of people like that, who changed the course of history. The history of art, that is. And allowed us the freedom to do what we want, basically. That's why these people became famous. I mean, some of the guys went completely overboard. And some of the work is shocking, in my view, and in a lot of people's view. But that's just the way it goes. But these people changed the history of art. I did history of art when I was doing a fine arts degree. It's one of the subjects, history of art. And you learn about these things. In the beginning of time, like in 400, I think before that it was everything was done two-dimensional. So if you drew something was two-dimensional, the head was a circle with no shading or anything, because it wasn't legal to make it look actually like a person. It had to be highly stylized because it was illegal. Yep, you heard it right. And I think somewhere in the 400s, I think it became illegal then to draw or paint somebody that it actually looked like a person. It was a three-dimensional, they had cheekbones, the shading to bring, you know, the nose out, and so on and so forth. But previous to that, they weren't allowed to. I mean, it was quite strict as well, I suppose. I'm not sure about the punishments. But nobody did it because they weren't allowed. and it was sacred. It was just not done. It was just not done. And then suddenly it became okay to donate somebody, to denote someone in a three-dimensional way. And that just changed everything. All of a sudden people could, you know, draw a person, and it didn't actually have to look like a two-dimensional statue. It could actually look like a person. And then once you could do three-dimensional stuff, sorry, I'm thinking at the same time I'm doing this, I should just be quiet for a moment while I'm concentrating and making this water. Okay, in a second, let me move everything out of the way. try not to rush. I just rushed that and went right over. So the name of the game is to just relax and go slowly. Especially as you know this is going to take an awful long time to complete anyway, so you may as well just relax and take your time. any of you wondering, I haven't got my microphone switched off. It's just that I'm concentrating and not talking. So. Sorry about that. Just follow along as I go. You can see it's very, very easy. So now we have a massive amount of water that is required in this area. So I think I might take the thicker pen, the 8. Throw it in so that you can see what I'm doing. Sorry, I don't know if I'm just talking loud enough then. Put it this way. Sorry about that, I thought I was on screen there, trying to sort it out so that you can see what I'm doing here. trying to get the feeling of water. In between those, we can do some thicker areas. I'm going to come out a little bit there. What this needs now is black circles. So I'm going to do some black circles now. And that'll fill it in. Oh, it's 56 minutes. So what I'll do is I'll switch off and switch on immediately and then have them as two separate. So it won't be a moment.